Hey everyone, Ralph here. In this video, I want to show you how you can get started with OpenAI's new Assistant API that was released earlier today. And it's going to be a simple example that allows you to understand how to use threads, how to use the polling mechanism to know when you have an answer. And we're going to be using the code interpreter so you understand how you can use these tools. Hopefully this will allow you to get started and understand how you can build with assistants and make something much more complicated. But enough about that, let's jump in and show you what the result will look like and then jump into the code. So all of the resources, the code, the dependencies, links, etc. that I'm using here is going to be available in a link in the video description to make sure that you look at that. You don't have to follow along and copy what I do on my screen. So check that. That has all of the resources along with a couple of steps that I'm not showing in this tutorial. One of the most important things that I would point out is going ahead and reading the documentation for the Assistance API. And again, I'm going to be linking that in the video description. Then let's look at what our outcome will be. I'm running Node locally on my Apple computer. And what I have set up is a script that will be asking me a question or allowing me to ask a question, provide me with an answer, and then asking if I have another question. And I can continue to ask questions about the context in the previous answer and continue having that context available for to me, question after question after question. So here I got a couple of questions that takes the Fibonacci sequence numbers, do some math on them, and can continue to do some math just to trigger that code interpreter that is running behind the scenes. But enough about that. I'll show you in a minute what this looks like in action, but let's actually go ahead and start building it. So I will be using VS Code here, or cursor in VS Code. So let's go ahead and create the first file, and let's go ahead and call that math teacher.jss. You can call it whatever you want. And then we're also going to be creating a file for our OpenAI API key. So let's call and create an environment variable for that, and then just hit save. And let's actually start with that. Let's start with the OpenAI API key here. I call it OpenAI API key. You can call it whatever you want. Just make sure that it is correctly spelled in the code that we have. So just save that in here. And then jump over to math teacher. And I'm not gonna code this as we go. I'm gonna be copy pasting some code and explaining it to speed this up. Nobody wants to see me code, and I don't want to put that on YouTube. So I'll just paste it as we go and explain what it is that we're doing. And again, this code, along with dependencies, etc., is available in a link in the video description. First of all, we're going to require .envs to make sure that we can import our environment variable. We're going to be using the OpenAI npm package. Note that it was updated this morning or earlier today. So if you already have OpenAI's npm package installed, make sure that you update it to the most recent version, because otherwise you won't have access to new features that were released today. And then I'm going to be using readline here that allows me to prompt or ask the user for input in our terminal. And then next, we're just going to be using plain vanilla OpenAI code to get the secret key, not technically OpenAI, but get that from the end variable here. And here we're using that to create a connection with OpenAI. Next, I got two different functions. I'm gonna copy paste both of them, and they essentially hold all of the logic that we're using in this tutorial. So first, I got a function that is called ask question, which just manages the prompt that we're providing the user, asking what is it that you want to ask, a lot of questions and asking there. But that is stored in this function that we called from within this main function. And this main function has the meat of our logic. It has basically everything. And it's ultimately what we call at the very end here to execute our logic. So let's walk through what that main function does. So if you have built with OpenAI in the past, you're going to be recognizing some of this, but it looks a little bit different. So in the OpenAI Assistant API, which is currently in beta, we have this assistant create. So you can provide a name. I think mine is math tutor because it's what in the docs. I copy pasted that. Then you provide instructions telling essentially the assistant, what is your purpose? What are you trying to do? And here you're a personal math tutor, write and run code to answer math questions. Then next, something that's very important to know is that you can ask or you can provide the assistant with tools, essentially capabilities that it can use to answer the questions or to solve the challenges or problems that it is provided with. We're going to be using the code interpreter, which allows it to run Python code behind the scenes. And then lastly, and importantly, the model is a new one that got released today, which has support for the assistants. It's called GPT-4-1106 because today is the 6th of November and it's currently in preview. So make sure to use this as your model when you're doing this tutorial. Next, let's move on to this. We're just logging a first greeting in the code, telling the user, hey there, I'm your personal math tutor. Ask me some complicated questions. And then we're on to some new OpenAI logic for assistants here. So I'll walk you through it step by step. So assistants are using something called threads. It's essentially the way that it keeps track of context over time. It's going to use what's called a thread. So we're creating a thread here, and we'll keep using that further down in the code. So we'll get back to using this thread. And then I'm using a little bit of state management here to know if we should continue running this code or to stop it. So I set a variable I call keep asking to true. And while keep asking is true, we're going to be executing some code. And what we're doing here first foremost is that we're calling out to the function that we created up here, passing in what is your question, and that will then prompt the user in the terminal, what is your question, and allowing the user to respond with whatever it is that we want to ask our assistant. And we get that back here. So we then move on to the next step. And here you can see we're continuing to use threads here. So you're using openai.beta.threads, then message, and we create a message. And note here that we're passing in the thread ID. So that's how we tell OpenAI that I already have a thread. I want to use that. I want to pass in some information into it. And the information that we're passing in is A, the role, which is the user. We're telling OpenAI that, hey, the user is providing something here. The content that we're providing in is the user question. So that's what the user put in as a question in the terminal. And then we're essentially creating something that is called run or runs. And this is just OpenAI executing whatever we've asked the assistant to do. And they do that in something that is called runs. And then something that is important to understand as well, with a lot of other OpenAI functionality, you send a request, you wait around, you get a response, and you can show that to your user. With assistants, it's a little bit different. So here we got to set up something that is called a polling mechanism. So what we're doing is we're setting run status. as a function of openai.beta.threads.runs and something called retrieve. So we're trying to get the status of a run to see, is it completed? Is it running? So we're passing in the thread ID that we have and the run ID, which is the current run that we're waiting for. I'm going to link something in the video description. I think it's important to walk through how these work. So I have a run lifecycle here that essentially explains what the different statuses are and how these runs are working. Because you need to sit and pull and wait for a run to be completed. You're not going to be told that it's completed. You have to check, is it done? Is it done? Is it done? And I set up this polling mechanism here to do that. And let me just add that this should be made more robust. So this is just something that I put together. It's pretty simple, but it won't capture errors and other things that might happen. So my polling mechanism just checks for this run status that we set here. If that is not yet completed, we're just gonna hang around for 2 seconds. Then we're gonna check again to see if it is completed. And if it isn't, we're just gonna, this while loop is just gonna loop that until it is set as completed. And this is where it should be made more robust, because if it's never get set as completed for whatever reason, well, this code never ends. So consider updating this to something better and more robust. I definitely will do eventually myself. Once this is completed, we're now going to be able to retrieve the messages that we have in our thread. So we do that here, const messages for the thread ID. We get a list of all of those, and that will contain all of the questions and answers that we've had. The first time there's only going to be one question, one answer, but as we continue to ask more questions, there are going to be more questions and answers. And in my case, I don't want to show all of them. I just want to show the most recent the most recent answer, because we're sort of adding to previous answers in the UI that we have in our terminal. So what we want to do here is just go ahead and get the most recent answer from the assistant. Again, we are the user, the assistant is providing the answer. So we want to make sure that we grab the message from the role assistant here. And then we're just going ahead and console logging that and showing the answer essentially. And next, we're going to be asking the user, do you want to continue with this? And if the answer is anything other than yes, we're going to be terminating the code and showing a little message here that says, alrighty then, I hope you learned something, and do this read line close. But if you answer, or if the user answers yes on this, we're just going to be looping this over again and rerunning all of this. And next time, if it's the second, third, fourth, etc., we're going to have all of that context available to us in the thread. Let's go ahead and look at this in action. So I'm going to open up my terminal here, and then we're going to do node mathteacher.js. So here we have it. Hello there, I'm your personal math tutor. Ask some complicated questions. And then we have this, what is your question? So let's ask something similar to what we asked previously. What are the 44th and say 66th Fibonacci numbers? I might be misspelling that. And now behind the scenes, it is running code interpreter and giving us a response here that says the 44th Fibonacci number is 4,433,000,000, and the 66th is something that I'm not sure what it's called in English, but it's a lot. So do we want to ask another question, yes or no? Let's go ahead and type yes, and then we're looping. So we're just getting this, what is your question again? Now, because we're using a thread here, the assistant is going to have context about our question and answer here. So we can go ahead and reference that same way that you can do with any chat agent where it has context of previous questions and answers. So let's go ahead and do this. Divide the latter with the former, then find the closest Fibonacci number to that and tell me its value and which order in the sequence it is. And then we hit enter. The same code is running, but now we're referencing this information right here. Code interpreter is going to take that, give us a number, and say that dividing this with the other is approximately 39,602. The closest Fibonacci number to this value is 46,368, which is the 24th number in the Fibonacci sequence. So you can continue asking additional questions, and it continues to essentially loop through this. But hopefully these two questions and answers sort of explains how this code is working in practice. So I'm just going to go ahead and type no here, and we get the last little bit here. Alrighty then, I hope you learned something. And that's sort of the message that I hope I can leave you with here as well. I hope you learned something here. This was a very scrappy tutorial with very scrappy code that I put together today, a few hours after this API and documentation was announced. Hopefully it can help you get started with the OpenAI Assistant API a little bit more quickly. That's sort of what I'm aiming for. I will put together some content in the future as well where I provide hopefully better code, some better and more fun use cases. So if you want to see those, make sure to subscribe to this channel. And if you can like the video, that's going to be helpful as well. But I'll leave it at that. Again, hope that this was useful, and maybe I'll see you in a future video. Thanks.